is a miracle to be here today. Welcome back. This is Kingdom Corn. Yeah. It is a great and beautiful day. Welcome, guys. I am so tremendously glad that you guys are here with me today. Whether you are here for the first time or a returning subscriber, thank you, guys. Today is going to be great. Kingdom Corn, appreciate you guys so very much. And because you guys are here, we are going to have an intergalactically great video today. Oh, yeah. So, if you guys have been on the Disney website, or of course, if you have been to Disney World, then you guys may have noticed they are selling this right here. This is the Star-Lord helmet, if you don't recognize. And if you don't know who Star-Lord is, I suggest you might come up out of that cave, come up out of that rock. Nah, but he is a member of the Guardians of the Galaxy. Here it goes. They are a team of intergalactic heroes. This here is Gamora. We got Drax, Rocket the Raccoon, or whatever he believes he is, Baby Groot. And we got Big Groot and the Man of the Hour, Star-Lord. And here is the Star-Lord helmet. Yeah. So, enough about the trivia stuff. Let's take a look at this out the box. Can you guys see this gorgeous plastic? It is almost a shiny metallic type of plastic. And it is marvelous. Well, it appears this plastic is to be taken a bit seriously. I hope you guys can notice what I'm seeing right here. I am totally not complaining about the look here. Now, I will say there are way better scuff marks on other helmets. These don't look very artsy, not very realistic. I mean, it doesn't look like it's dirty. It's just like it's clearly actually some paint on it. And it doesn't actually look like someone scraped off some metal. So, the details here definitely could be a lot better. I mean, I have seen a lot better on other helmets. Now, take a look at the back on the inside. I love it when they put details into the parts that you even can't see. It just lets the whole thing look way more authentic. They have some goggle-style eye holes. And dig this. Whoa. Now you have those red lenses that he looks through so that you can be totally legit out here on these galactic streets. Now you guys may have noticed a battery tray in the back right now. Let's go ahead and get these batteries inside so that we can see what type of electronic functions that this guy really has. What do you know? Batteries already included. Yes! I might want to hit this switch right here.
We can do this, right? I am Groot.
Okay. Apparently you touch this button.
I am Groot. Rocket, translate. Would it kill you to learn something new?
Clearly this voice is not from Chris Pratt.
Rocket, you there? What do you want, Quill?
On the other hand, Rocket sounds like Rocket from the movie. Maybe Chris Pratt wasn't available.
I'm the best pilot in the galaxy. I was literally engineered to pilot ships. Groot, you there? Groot, pay attention. I am Groot.
Did we already hear that one?
Let's have a dance off.
Oh, yeah, we gotta do that.
Anyone seen my mixtape?
No, sir.
Quill, get back to the ship. Copy that.
You got the dialogue with Drax and other members of the team. I am Groot.
We're the Guardians of the Galaxy.
I don't know, man. Like, I mean, that voice is really throwing me off because they went and got the most generic voice that they could find. And I kind of see Star-Lord as more than just a generic character.
Come on, guys. Call me Star-Lord.
Yeah, that voice is not getting it for me.
Anyone seen my mixtape? We can do this, right? I am Groot. Let's have a dance-off.
Well, it appears that I have cycled through all of the different voices here. So there's not very, very much, but there is a little variety.
Yeah. So now, let's get to the real business. Does this fit on my head so that I can become a real Guardian of the Galaxy? Yeah. It is time to check it out. I can do this. Woo. Now, I'm not sure how good this is fitting, but all right, there we are. This has an interesting fit. Like, it doesn't, like, smother your head. There's so much space here on the mouth part. And as you guys saw earlier, there's, like, goggles on the eyes so that your eyes aren't, like, all the way up on here. I can see pretty good through the red lenses. Everything looks like blood. But that's okay. Cool. Now all I need is me a good team. Hey, on that note, if you guys want to be a part of the team, you guys want to be a Kingdom Man, I would like to invite you guys to go ahead and subscribe. That way you guys can always be in the kingdom and I will have a full-blown galactic team in my corner. Guardians of the Kingdom. Woo!
It's sweaty in there. So as for my opinions, as for my final thoughts, I mean, what can I say? I'm not sure how close this is to the actual Hasbro version. I know that the Hasbro version, it has a back to it. This has no back. All this has is the little string thingy, like those old Halloween masks. At a $50 price point compared to $100, it is not a feature that I'm missing too much. It still fits perfectly. I am a little disappointed at the voices. They really put the bare minimum as far as voices and sound effects. I mean, this whole thing is just bare minimum, but it is a very nice looking helmet. It's nice and shiny metallic, got the red lenses, and it fits on my head. So yeah, guys, that pretty much wraps up my review. I hope you guys had as much fun as I did, and y'all be staying tuned, because those giveaways are right around the corner. Ah, yeah. And on that note, anything is possible if you believe. You guys go out there, keep believing, and hopefully I will see you guys next time. This is Kingdom Corn. We out. Peace and much love. Yeah.